Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to set up a project in Tracktion 7 and then go over the basic layout of the project and where some of the important tools are that we'll need for editing. Before starting, make sure you check out our first video in this series where we covered how to get Tracktion 7 installed on our system and configured with an audio interface. When we first open Tracktion 7, we'll need to open or start a new project. Our recent projects are available at the top, and it even has projects available from Tracktion 6 if you previously used that program. We'll start by creating a new project instead. When we do this, we give it a name, and we can choose to change the project location on our computer or keep it at default. I won't be using a project template for this tutorial. The project doesn't automatically open when we create it, so we have to click on the new project name it created to launch it. Let's start with the left panel. The default view is our files list, which allows us to access things like music files in a specific folder. The default is the documents folder, but we could easily change it. Next is the tracks panel. Here we can either disable or hide tracks. If we disable a track, it doesn't play or show up in the track view, but it's not deleted and we can go back and add it again after. If we hide a track, it remains playing but doesn't show up in the track view. Next is search, which can be used to search for presets and plugins. Then we have a section for notifications, one for markers, which we can add at the bottom, and one for the clipboard. If we want to hide this entire panel, we can click the button in the top left and that will maximize the space available for our tracks. Now let's cover the track section. At the top, we have the time indicator. This is set to bars right now, but we can change that in the bottom left to seconds under the timecode section. You can also right-click on the time area to change it. Next, we can have a bar for tempo and markers. To enable the tempo bar, click the tempo button to the right. With the tempo bar, we can change the time signature throughout the project, and the options for this are shown in the bottom panel. First, we can set the time that the time signature changes at. By default, we're just going to be at the beginning of the project. Below that, we can set the time signature and put it in triplets if we want. To change the time signature at this point in the project, we set the time to that point. Then click Insert Time Signature at Cursor. From there, we can insert a new time signature. We can use the Delete tool in the bottom right to undo this. To change the tempo itself, double-click on the line on the tempo track and add a new tempo change. Then we'll get a control at the bottom, allowing us to change the time of the tempo change and the tempo itself. Underneath, we can open the markers bar in the same way as the tempo. At the bottom, this allows us to add markers based on bars and beats or absolute time. Bars and beats will reposition themselves if you change the tempo, but the absolute time markers will not. To the right, we have a few buttons to disable sections of the window. The top left button disables track inputs, the top right button disables the mixer, and the bottom button removes the entire bottom control panel. In the bottom left of the window, we have a lot more controls and menus. First are the undo and redo buttons that work like any other program. Then we have save, which we can save the project and the template, but this doesn't save the audio file of the project. Clipboard can be used for cutting, copying, and pasting. Import can add audio tracks to the project from elsewhere on your system. Export allows us to create an audio file from the project. Next, we have the timecode, which we can change between time and beats and bars, like we saw when we looked at the tempo. After that, we can create a click track, and we'll look at that when we record audio. Next, we have an option to enable snapping and to add more tracks to the project. The bottom right section of the window has the transport controls and a few buttons that we'll want quick access to while we're using the program. At the top, we have the tempo and time signature, along with the current timecode in minutes and seconds, or beats and bars. The tempo and time signature can't be changed from here. Instead, it displays the current tempo and time signature at this point in the project. Under that, we have the automation read and write, the play button, and the record button. Below that, there's the panic button if the software glitches and creates noise, the jump to start button, rewind, and fast forward. We can insert plugins on the master channel, pan, adjust volume, and monitor the levels. The ones we'll want to take note of are the loop to loop a section, click to enable the click track, and snapping. Thanks for checking out this video on the layout of Tracktion 7. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check out our social media links in the video description to see more of our new content.